Hey there, and welcome back to the KCRA 3 Experience at the Arden Fair Mall. Today we're talking about pet arthritis and signs and treatments that can help you prevent your Fido from getting arthritis. Today we're here with Dr. Ken Pawlowski from the Banfield Pet Hospital in Folsom, and this is Fozzie Bear, one of my favorite guests ever, I must say. Fozzie came over to my house for a segment one day,
and
we had
a
lot of fun. And now, these are not designer bike shorts he's wearing here.
Can you tell me a little bit about what they are? Yes, they're actually, it's a new form of treatment for arthritis in dogs, and it helps to actually regenerate cartilage growth. It's the only thing that's been demonstrated to actually regrow cartilage in dogs. And so they wear this device 4 to 6 to 8 hours a day for 2 to 4 months, and that treatment can last for 6 to 8 months. And he does have a little bit of hip arthritis, and I was actually able to take him off his anti-inflammatory medication for about 6 months after he went on that.
That is incredible, and he doesn't seem to mind. Actually, he doesn't seem to mind the shaved booty either. Take a look at that. All right, so I won't embarrass you anymore, Fozzie Bear. Let's talk a little bit about some of the signs of arthritis so we can tell if our dog is getting arthritis. Look, I think I upset him. He's turning around now, hiding his booty. So some of the signs of arthritis: they become less active, they start walking slower, they get swollen joints, and refusal, and then fever. Now, what do you mean by refusal?
Refusal, so not jumping up on the bed or jumping up into the car. That was one of the things I know with Fozzie. He wasn't jumping up into the back of the car. Maybe not wanting to go up steps, so not doing things that they normally used to do. A lot of times we think it's, they're just getting older, but they may have other things going on. It's not just age.
Now, is it true that it only affects older and bigger dogs?
Absolutely not. There are, as it said, fever. There are different causes of arthritis. So there are infectious causes. There can be autoimmune causes, like rheumatoid arthritis. And then there are dogs, everybody's most heard of hip dysplasia, where they're born with the joints that don't fit right. Mm-hmm. And they can start developing problems less than a year of age.
So what are some of the treatments for dogs that do start exhibiting signs of arthritis?
Well, early on, there may be some surgical options. So that's why it's important at the first stages, especially in young dogs, to have that checked out. But after that, there are a variety of treatments. There are supplements that can be used, especially in the early stages. There are new diets that are developed. And then when they do have a lot of pain and inflammation, we do have some excellent anti-inflammatory medications that really can make older dogs start acting like puppies again.
Okay, so some of the treatments we have here: antibiotics, anti-inflammatories you just mentioned, antioxidant vitamins, cortisone, and then of course this stim pouch that Fozzie Bear here is wearing. And you mentioned that this kind of treatment can actually also work on humans as well,
in theory. Yes, it was actually developed for use in humans, and it's FDA approved and Medicare approved.
I think I might get this for my mom, but in the meantime, if I wanted to get it for Allie, if she ends up getting arthritis, how much is this going to set me back?
It's called the Bionicare system, and somewhere between $1,000 and $1,500, depending on whether you're renting it for one treatment or you want to get it for the lifetime of the pet. And you can see a veterinarian and they can get it set up for you with that. And I can tell you it's far less expensive than the human version.
I bet it is. Well, thank you so much
for
being
here.
And thank you, Fozzie Bear, a great guest as always.